The research that is done at the SSRL Material Science Division has had an impact in energy materials technologies, principally photovoltaics and batteries, as well as to some extent fuel cells. And it's done this mostly by allowing the researchers who make the materials to better understand what they make, how they are made, and how they operate.
One of the main efforts at SSRL is to study materials in situ, so during processing, and also while they're operating. This gives us a good idea of what's actually happening in the material as you're using it.
We develop instrumentation that can use X-rays to explore materials in situ, such as materials going through height temperature changes rapidly, or batteries, like probing inside a battery, looking at photovoltaic surfaces and understanding the structure and what makes the photovoltaics efficient.
We can watch things happen on actually operating conditions. This is very beneficial because a lot of times if you don't do this in situ, you'll miss a lot of the important interactions and behaviors of the material.
It is important to understand the structure and how it affects the efficiency of a cell. That different structures have different efficiencies, and some structures we don't know about, and so we measure them here and find out which structures are optimum for solar cells.
To advance energy production and sustainability, we're entering now an era where we need more precise control of everything we study. And this requires advanced tools, and we have this wonderful source here of X-rays. That means that we can tune in and understand the electronic structure with unprecedented sensitivity. And in particular, we're interested to peel off precise aspects of this electronic structure that is important for a certain process.
The Stanford Synchrotron Radiation Light Source has partnerships with Stanford University, as well as some of the local industries in the Bay Area, namely some small companies, as well as some larger companies such as Applied Materials. We help them to understand the materials they make and ultimately make and better control these materials.
Well, we have enjoyed a very close collaboration with SSRL, and this has helped us to obtain research support from industry like Samsung Electronics and Ford Motors. And this has enabled us to develop new technologies such as high energy batteries for the automobile and consumer electronics industry. And this would not be possible without the technical expertise of what's available here at SSRL.
Our work here benefits the environment and the economy because we're working on materials used for energy generation and energy storage. Ultimately, if we can improve upon these, we can move away from our dependence upon fossil fuels towards more sources of clean and renewable energy.
The work we're doing here at SSRL on battery research is going to allow us to have longer lasting batteries so that we can have electric vehicles that can replace what fossil fuels are doing right now. Using X-ray microscopy on batteries, we are able to look at the batteries, the inside of the batteries, while they're operating. So we can look at the changes that are happening in the morphology of the anode and the cathode material. We're also able to look at the chemical changes in the actual image as the battery is operating as well.
Research here at SSRL is enabling us to reduce the use of expensive materials and also improve the longevity and the reliability of these materials, therefore allowing us to lower the cost of having efficient energy storage and conversion technologies. When we develop and deploy these technologies in developing countries, they have to be available and affordable at small scale. Therefore, we are looking at technology that we can deploy at the single household level rather than at the city or the urban level.
Many users come here to do all different kinds of research. So we're exposed to things that not only are we interested in personally, but many different universities from all over the world doing all different kinds of research. So if you get that many scientists in one room talking about different things, you're bound to have ideas that you just wouldn't expect.
SSRL has been instrumental in getting us insight on how these processes take place in these technologies.
We think that we can close the gap between a scientific hypothesis and scientific discovery, and also ensure that the best ideas from entities that cannot afford these type of techniques, they can come here and we can ensure that the best ideas get studied with the best tools. And this would speed up scientific discovery, which translate to more scientific discoveries and future technologies.